Hey my beautiful people, how are you all? Today I'm gonna show you how you can wear a cotton silk sari in a way to look effortlessly beautiful. You guys have showed your love on my previous videos, and if you are a new viewer, then I would like to request you to watch my previous videos on sari draping, and links are in the description box below. And also stay tuned to the end of this video as well. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to never miss out any latest updates. So without any further ado, let's start today's video. As you can see, I have gathered the extra clothes of this petticoat in front for a cleaner look and worn this black turtleneck sweater as a blouse for today's look. And let me give you the tips before wearing that put on the footwear that you are gonna use so that the fall of the sari would be perfect of length. Start tucking the sari from the middle front of the petticoat this way. As I always divide the sari drape in 6 easy steps, and this is the first step that is completed now by tucking, and now is the second step is to gather the another round to determine the length of the pallu. Now keep the length of the pallu according to your height, and I would suggest to keep the length at least up to your knee or a little below. Let's go forward with the third step first, and we'll complete the pallu once we are done with the front pleats. And the next step is the fall pleats, of course, and for pleats I am taking the middle section of the sari and started making pleats using my hand palm and the two main fingers, I mean one is thumb and another is the little finger, and keep wrapping the fabric following the same process up to the last. And the fourth step is the loose fabric that we will show up as the hip pleats, and nothing complex here, just tuck it tightly into your petticoat, no more complexities of using numerous safety pins. Fifth step is to make even and parallel pleats from the both ends, inner and the outer, and make those pleats even one by one. And can you see? When I am pulling the inner end of the pleats are also coming in place from the front also, and it's visible clearly. Now simply shake the pleat portion holding the both ends of the pleats tightly so that the remaining fabric, if any is left, will also be parallelized. Though this fabric is not a hard one to drape, one can easily tame over this sari. And if you see that any extra clothes are gathered in the beginning of the pleats, do one thing, adjust the first pleat by making it bigger compared to the other one, like this. And this is easy, right? Now it is the time to arrange the pleats for the final. Adjust the hip section's fabric as we didn't use any safety pin till now. Hold the pleats all together and keep moving your fingers by pressing the fabric and tuck these all at a time. Now what's with this fluffy part? Don't worry, we have a solution. Loosen this part a little, and what we need to do? Keep it pulling behind. Just pull the extra fabric towards the back. Yes, and unveil the back, that is the pallu section, and cover up like this way. Done. So that is the pleats, and that is the clean and tidy pleats are ready. And the sixth step is to make the shoulder pleats. For pleats you need to do the same like before as we did with the front pleats, but make smaller pleats. Remember, the more you spread your fingers while wrapping, the size of the pleats will be wider, and vice versa. And for the shoulder pleats, always try to make smaller pleats, so keep your thumb and smallest finger close to each other. Shoulder pleats take time, so be patient with it. This is the part that will sit on your bust area. Now even and parallelize the pleats across the length one by one. And the same thing will be continued till the last end, from where your pallu is raised behind your back. Always remember, never leave the first end of the pallu until you can't make even pleats on the first part. And I am talking about the first part that is being held by my left hand on up. See, I have zoomed so you can watch how I am picking the folds one by one. Okay, I have almost done, but here also you need to make even folds on the hip section for a nicer look. Hold one by one and keep pulling behind so that each folds can be visible over the hip area as well, like the bust area. And when you are done, hold the pleats all together. See, I have folded the pallu but didn't leave it open. Now secure it with a safety pin, unless your all of the endeavors can go to waste in a second. And you don't want this, right? And I'm using another safety pin to keep it more secure from behind as well, though we will remove it later. Now keep the pallu all together on your shoulder and adjust the pleats like this way. Clean, right? Now if you have any loosening fabric behind, pull and tuck this near the front pleats and make it smooth. So finally we are almost done. Now I have accessorized a little and you can carry this look at office or school or college by wearing simply. And this kind of turtleneck sweater as a blouse with sari goes just fab. It is super comfy and full of elegance at the same time. Next, I'm gonna show you the second look that you can add on. Yes, if you have this kind of long coat or a trench coat, you can also layer it upon the turtleneck sweater. Just pull out the pallu from inside carefully and put it on the shoulder. Now adjust the pleats a little, like this way. And yeah, I have used a belt also, and this belt matches with my sweater and also with the golden neck piece. Choose a belt that matches your attire. Look, sari can be worn by anyone. It is not difficult at all, but picking a right sari accessories is the most styling factor. Now, I will show you the third look, and that is with the shawl, and I have chosen this velvet one, which enhances the whole look to another level. This look can easily be carried at any daytime wedding function as well. What do you think? So, I hope you loved three of the looks of today, and which one you loved the most, let me know in the comments. Do like and subscribe with your family and friends, and I will see you on my next video. Bye! Thanks for watching!